Alright guys, we're going to do a little DVD hunting. I'm going to hit up a few thrift stores. But first, I need to stop at USPS, ship off a couple packages. I do sell all of my rare finds on eBay, so I'm going to link my eBay store if you guys want to check those out, possibly purchase them, in the description below. Alright, so we're going in one of my favorite thrift stores. It's the Arclight thrift store. Going to check out if they have any good buys. I'm usually here once a week, see if they stocked up over the weekend. Funny, I actually just bought this on DVD sealed, and they just added this here. I haven't seen an HD DVD in a while. I guess this was in the competition of when HD and Blu-ray, I believe. They didn't know who was going to win the battle, and Blu-ray won. So I just have a mother load right now, 14 films for under $30. I got some great rare finds too, I'll show you. Alright guys, so my first pickup was To Wong Fu, Thanks for Everything, Julie Newmar. Now this features Wesley Snipes, Patrick Swayze, and John Leguizamo, probably like you've never seen him before. Roughly remember this movie. Oh, also it's sealed for only $2, that's great. I do remember that this movie, I believe, is about them going across country to a drag competition or drag pageant. So it's kind of like their hijinks on the road. I remember always this being a really funny movie, especially John Leguizamo's character. So yeah, this is definitely a good, I believe, 90s flick. I'm not sure of the year, but I remember this being really funny, so I'm glad I got it sealed in the packaging. Alright, now my next pickup was Myra Breckinridge, played by Raquel Welch. And now this one, I haven't seen it, but what I've read, it's, I believe she's a transgender, wanting to go to Hollywood. She's battling with alter egos, with her alter ego. And I believe it was very just controversial for its time. 1970s when it was released. Wild, weird, sexy, and strange is how they marketed it. So I heard this one's pretty good. It's going for some pretty good money on eBay, so I had to pick it up. Now here's another pickup, A Dirty Shame, which I don't know too much about. I have not seen it, but it has some pretty cool characters. Tracy Ullman, Johnny Knoxville, Chris Isaac as well, Selma Blair. It's a John Waters film. Looks like a raunchy comedy. I don't know too much about it. Like I said, it is NC-17, which kind of like intrigued me a little bit. I haven't seen too many movies out there that are NC-17, especially over-the-counter sold. So I picked this one up. Don't know too much about it, but looks interesting. Alright, here's another one of my pickups. It stars Edward Furlong and Christina Ricci. Now, I have not even heard of this movie, but I always see the cover. Another John Waters film. John Waters did Hairspray, I believe. Oh yeah, Pink Flamingos as well. Alright, so this one right here is about Edward Furlong's character kind of stalking his girlfriend, Christina Ricci, kind of documenting all her moves. He takes a lot of weird pictures, and he gets recognized for his weird pictures or unique art. This one's just another wacky comedy from John Waters, so looking forward to that. Heard the soundtrack's really good too. Plus, I haven't seen Edward Furlong thin in a film since Terminator 2, so I don't know his track record too much, but this one seems interesting, so yeah. And this is the ultimate pickup right here, Hot Shots. If you do not know about Hot Shots came before all of the other parody movies that you guys know and love, like Scary Movie, Epic Movie, Dance Flick, all those Wayans Brother films where they're parodying everything else. I remember this parodies like Top Gun, all those like Army, Navy type films, and this one is flawless. Hot Shots was starring Charlie Sheen, I forget the old man's name. It's just a great flick. It makes me laugh every single time. And I mean, it still holds true after all this time. It's 1991. Pick this one up if you guys don't have it. Add it to your collection. All right, now this is another cool find. Mortal Thoughts, starring Demi Moore, Bruce Willis, Harvey Keitel. This one right here I have not seen, but from what I understand, it's a psychological thriller. Harvey Keitel always plays a cop in these movies, I swear. And he's pretty much just asking Demi Moore's character because something tragic did happen. I'm not going to get too much into the details, but this one looks like a good psychological thriller from the early 90s, so definitely check this one out. Okay, now I know a lot of you guys are going to laugh at me, but I had to pick up Bible Man, A Light in the Darkness. Now, I don't know how many Bible Mans there are, but this is only $1, so I had to pick it up. Look at that cover alone. I don't know much about it, but I know it's being parodied a lot on YouTube, so I really just wanted to check it out for myself. And, I don't know the story too much. I just know it's a religious type of movie targeted towards kids. So, I mean, you can't beat Bible Man for less than $1. So I'm going to check this one out. I might do a review on this one right here, like a reaction video or something like this, because this is outrageous to me. I don't even know the year it came out. Oh, it looks like early 2000s, so... I mean, this looks... Look at that. That looks so dated from the 70s, but it came out in the early 2000s, so... Looks pretty funny. Had to pick that one up. All right, another one of my pickups is Wild Reeds. I don't know anything about this film. I know it's set in France, 1962. Won a lot of awards, it looks like. Winner of the Best Foreign Film. I did look this one up, and it is rare and out of print. It is going for some money on eBay. I know it's a coming-of-age film centered around four teenagers dealing with their sexuality. So this one looks pretty interesting. I might check this one out. But I know this one is rare and out of print, so if you guys find this one, pick it up. All right, now I'm really excited to add this one to my collection, Serial Mom. If you guys have not seen this one, please see it. This is such a good, quirky, dark comedy, Kathleen Turner as a serial mom. I remember it has Ricky Lake, I forget the other brother's name or whatever. Just a quirky comedy of like, it kind of reminds me of like almost like the mom's like a Stepford Wife. Like she's really perfect, like a 70s type mom. She dresses like in these dainty dresses and stuff like that. But when like anything goes wrong, she has like a crazy alter ego temper. Haven't seen this one since whenever it came out, whenever I was a kid. It came out in 1994, so I remember seeing it probably in the late 90s. Just a dark, I wouldn't categorize it as a horror comedy, but I mean, she goes on the serial rampage, and it's just a really fun movie, so make sure to add this to your collection if you guys do pick it up. Unfortunately, it's one of these snap cases, which I hate. They always usually get really damaged. Not like a regular DVD case, but yeah, pick up Serial Mom if you can. Alright, now my next pickup is Velvet Goldmine. I have not seen this film or heard anything about it. I looked it up. It looks like it's rare. I know it's starring Ewan McGregor from Trainspotting, Star Wars Episode 1, Christian Bale, Jonathan Myers, who plays a kind of like a David Bowie type of character, like a glam rock 80s rock star, and he fakes his own death to go into hiding to avoid the spotlight or get out of the spotlight. And an investigative reporter kind of digs a little deeper and finds out that he faked his own death. So it's pretty, looks like a pretty cool movie. I'm going to have to check this one out for sure. But this is a rare find from what I looked up. And you should definitely add it to your collection if you find it. All right, now my next find is My Beautiful Laundrette. I believe it's how you pronounce it. It's Daniel Day-Lewis. Now, most of you guys remember Daniel Day-Lewis as the bad guy, or the main bad guy in Gangs in New York. Now, I know I do. That's the first time I saw him back in the early 2000s. But this is a film from 1985. He's really young here. The story pretty much is he has an alcoholic father. He wants to do more with his life, but his dad's always kind of like bringing him down. His friend over here wants to help him out and puts him in control of this laundromat. So it's kind of like almost like a coming-of-age type of film, just showing you his different situations. I believe it takes place in London. This is a pretty good find right here, so if you guys can get it, grab it. All right, now my next find is pretty cool. I think someone just must have brought in a bunch of cool, rare 80s and 90s films, because this is like the most pickups I've done in a while. This one right here is Torch Song Trilogy. Immediately drawn to it because the star is Matthew Broderick, and he looks so young in this film right here. Now, I forget this actor's name next to him, but I remember him from Mrs. Doubtfire. He plays the brother of Robin Williams. You guys know exactly who I'm talking about. He has a raspy voice. He's such a good, funny actor. Now, this one right here, I don't know too much about. I read that it's kind of like a rom-com. It follows these four, just dealing with relationships, and they're from New York City, so it's just all interaction right there. I believe that's their mother. So it just talks about the different relationships between everybody, all the friends, and I heard this one's a good one, so I might check this one out soon. All right, so my next pickup is Puppetry of Penis. Now, this just screamed I had to freaking get it. I love weird and obscure stuff like this. Now, I remember seeing this on the shelves when it was for rent. Don't know too much about it other than these guys are puppeteers with their penis. They're from Australia. This might be like a live show type, But this one was pretty rare. I didn't see too many people having it on eBay, so I think I'm going to give this one a watch and then try to sell it. But yeah, this one right here, Puppetry of Penis. I don't think it really needs any explanation as far as the plot. It says the ancient art of genital origami live at the Forum. So it is a live show. But yeah, I'm going to check this one out and see what I think. Now this is the cream of the crop pickup right here. Another John Waters film. So it must have been John Waters Day. Everybody just decided to just donate all their John Waters films. Polyester. Now this one right here is going for some serious money on eBay. I'm talking $30 to $80 I saw it for. Now it's starring Divine, who was in Hairspray, Pink Flamingos. A lot of you guys will remember her from Hairspray. But this is so weird right here. It features an Odorama card inside. Now, I don't even know what the hell this is. I don't want to try smelling it, but this is so cool. Anyways, the story is, in a nutshell, Divine plays a wife who finds out that her husband secretly is a pornographer. That's his job. And he's been cheating on her. Alongside with that, to make matters worse, she finds out her daughter's pregnant, so they're dealing with that. Also, she finds out that her best friend, I believe, is a mistress of the husband, so there's a lot of stuff going on. This is a very rare one, so I'm so glad that I picked this one up. It's in great condition right here. Like I said, it's going for some serious money. As far as serious money goes for a rare or out-of-print DVD on eBay, so yeah, glad I picked this one up right here. Glad I jumped on this one because there was a lot of hunters today. So we're going to head to the next location. All right, off to the next thrift store, which is really cool because this one is literally right across the street. So Super Thrift Store right there. It's a Rescue Mission thrift store. So we're going to check out what we can find today. All right, so once again, this is another packed thrift store. Mondays are always really packed. This is weird. I found a copy of The Mummy Returns, but it looks like, yeah, it's a screener for your consideration copy. So I don't even know how people get these, but they sure sell them. Okay, so unfortunately, nothing good there. I mean, I was there last week, and it doesn't look like they updated at all. The bad thing about that thrift store is, unfortunately, a lot of people will steal the disc, or they'll put one disc in another movie and sell it to them that way. I mean, I don't know if they intentionally do that, or if people, like customers, just take them out and switch them out. But a lot of those cases are usually really damaged, so. But I mean, I have found a couple of things there that are pretty rare or out of print, but unfortunately, nothing good today. The ARC Foundation Thrift Store, another ARC, but in a different city. Alright, so I'm really excited. I picked up about 6 more DVDs. About 3 of them are out of print, so I'm going to show you guys what I picked up in a second. Alright, so I'm going to go over these really quick because I don't want this video to be too long. So, The Howling Reborn I just picked up. Now, it's an Anchor Bay release, and I always go to Anchor Bay automatically because Anchor Bay is an out-of-print company. So, a lot of these get a limited run, or you just won't see them again. Kind of rare. I mean, I know this is a newer one, but so for a couple bucks, it doesn't hurt to hold on to these for a little bit. Secondly, some Patrick Swayze film I had never seen or ever even heard about. I believe it's Tiger Warsaw. So I have no clue, but I know that anything Patrick Swayze is badass. So this one looks pretty vintage right here. Looked it up. I don't think it's out of print, but it's definitely a rare find. And oddly enough, I know you guys might think, what the hell is he picking this one up for? This one right here clocked in at over $30. So this one right here is a rare find. It includes a DVD plus a CD. I know it might sound crazy, but if you guys are on the DVD hunt, make sure to check out how much the Thomas and Friends, the older ones, are worth. So this one right here, I believe, oh, yep, there it is right there, an Anchor Bay release. I don't know the year of this. It's showing a bunch of different years, so Yeah, it was. It's also told by George Carlin, so that's actually probably ups the value a little bit. So right there, Thomas and Friends, that one's going for a lot on eBay. Now I hit up another thrift store right across the street, picked up a couple out of print ones that I found immediately. The Last Emperor. This is a great film right here. Excellent condition. It's an artisan. You always want to look for artisan as well because those are out of print sometimes. So Last Emperor, going for some good money on eBay. Catch 22. Don't know much about it. I believe it's an army film. I believe it might be a comedy, is what it said, set in the 1940s. So right here, this is actually going for some good money on eBay. Catch 22. This film, I believe I've seen parts of it. I think it's about the rave scene called Groove. This one right here is definitely out of print. It's going for about 15 to 20 bucks on eBay. So definitely check that one out, Groove. And this is the creme de la creme. For some reason, Apocalypto is out of print. So if you guys find this Mel Gibson movie, Apocalypto, I've actually never seen it, surprisingly. I know they made a kind of a big deal about it, how the people were portrayed in the times of the Mayan people. But definitely check this one out right here. This one is out of print. So search for it on eBay. It's going for some pretty decent money. So yeah, that one's cool. All right, so I'm clocking in at about over 30 DVDs I've picked up so far. But I'm not stopping. I got one more thrift store stop to make. So it seems like Mondays are really busy days for thrift stores. So I'm going to start going probably every Monday, every other Monday. But one thing I forgot to mention is make sure you guys are looking for out-of-print companies. That's one thing that I learned from Sean C. Phillips, the biggest Blu-ray and DVD hunter that I know on YouTube. I get a lot of inspiration from him. And he said to check out Anchor Bay, Artisan DVDs. I also look for Mill Creek. Sometimes they have a lot of good out-of-print and rare films as well. So make sure to keep those companies in mind when you're doing your DVD hunting. All right, now this, I swear, is my last stop of the day. It is the Boys and Girls Club thrift store right here. This one has a very small parking lot. So let's see if I can actually pull up right here in the front. Always love supporting Boys and Girls Club, so it's cool that they have their own thrift store over here. Let's see what we can find. All right, so one thing, I see a white chalkboard out here and it has some deals. Happy weekday deals. Looks like all white and red tags are half off. Sweet, let's see what we can find. So I've already started a little pile for DVDs I'm gonna get. I'm still scouring over a lot of these. All right, so I think I seriously have an addiction, but I picked up some good ass finds. This comedy I've never heard of called Lucky. It was for Emmy consideration. Sealed up, only a couple bucks. It's worth about 20 on eBay. Superman, a little piece of home. This one is steel sealed. Got it for like a buck 95. Cartoons always go for pretty well on eBay and Amazon. Haha, badass pickup right here. Metallica Live right here, only picked it up for about a buck. This is going actually for about 20 bucks on eBay. Huge Metallica fan, grew up on them, so I'm very stoked about this one. All right, picked up this film, Diptropia. I don't know too much about it. I believe it's like an artsy type urban documentary. Let's see. Oh, it says from the directors of Jesus Camp, which was an insane documentary. If you guys haven't checked out Jesus Camp, check that out now. This one, official selection. Winner for editing, winner by grand jury prize for independent. So yeah, I won a lot of awards. Actually, I might check this one out then. But yeah, got this for about a buck too. It's going for some money on eBay. Haha, Nonsense. Probably the best title ever right here. This one is rare right here. I believe it's a comedy musical type. Might be like a live theater. Featuring Rue McClanahan from The Golden Girls. So that's her right there. Right there on the front as well. This is also rare. Got it for a couple bucks. Another comic movie, Justice League Unlimited, Saving the World. Also sealed as well. This is always gonna go for some good money on eBay. Make sure you guys pick these up. It's good for the kids. To Live and Let Die, a 007 film. This one is just recently out of print, I read. So yeah, they're not gonna be making this one anymore. So make sure you pick this one up. Yeah. Roger Moore as James Bond is actually a pretty cool 007, so definitely pick up To Live and Let Die if you can. If you guys already have it in your collection, make sure you hold on to this. This is now out of print. This one right here, Francis Ford Coppola right here, presents Rumblefish. I have not even heard of this one, but it looks cool. It looks like a Outsiders, you know, coming of age type of film right here. I see that it has Matt Dillon, Mickey Rourke, Dennis Hopper, Nicolas Cage, and all these guys look really, really young. So this looks like a really cool one. I believe this one is out of print. If not, it is rare. This one right here took me by surprise. So this is Michael Douglas, Kathleen Turner, and Danny DeVito. There's little Danny right there. The War of the Roses. Have no clue what this is even about, but it is rare. I checked up on this, and it's going for some decent scratch on eBay. So make sure you guys pick this one up. Next, we got Bill Murray in Meatballs. This is a sealed package as well. It says, before teaming up with Stripes and Ghostbusters, director Ivan Reitman and Bill Murray bring you their first collaboration in Meatballs. So if you guys want to see a young Bill Murray, check this one out right here. And last but not least, ooh, my guilty pleasure right here. This is 80s gold. Actually, it's the 80s? Oh, this is actually 91. I don't know why it feels like an 80s film, but this is Christina Applegate in Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter is Dead. This is freaking awesome. If you guys love these, like, real, like, quirky comedies, kind of like more on the preteen, like, teenager level, I remember seeing this one right here. This one is really, really cool. It says it's Home Alone times 5. But, yeah, I definitely saw it when I was older. It's pretty much the mom puts this like, Mrs. Doubtfire nanny in there who's really, like, a Nazi, and the kids hate her. And then she just, you know, kills over dead. And now the kids are kind of scrambling, trying to figure out what to do. But if you guys pick this one up, I don't believe it's out of print or anything, but I had to pick it up and add it to my collection. It is sealed as well. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, hit that like button. Make sure to subscribe. I'm going to be doing a lot more videos like this. Going to try to hit up thrift stores or pawn shops at least once a week. So remember, thumbs up this, share it, leave a comment below if you guys saw any that I kind of overlooked and they were actually rare out of print. I might have to run back over there and catch it. But all right, see you guys later.